5th August 2021, morning newly, Shanti Bhartada Madhuban. Sweet children, Baba has come to awaken your fortune. Only by becoming pure will your fortune be awakened. Question: what are the signs of the children whose fortune has been awakened? Answer: they became deities of happiness. They claim their inheritance of happiness from the unlimited Father and make everyone happy. They can never cause anyone sorrow. They are children of Vyas, Sukhdev, true bestowers of happiness. Second point, they have renounced the five vices and are called true Raj Yogis, Raj Rishis. Third point, their stage remains constant and stable. They can never cry about anything. They are called conquerors of attachment. Psalm: my fortune having been awakened, I have come. Om Shanti. When you hear the line of the song, your sweetest children should have goose pimples. It is a common song, but no one else knows the meaning of it. Only the Father comes and explains the meaning of all those songs and scriptures to you. Your sweetest children also know that in the Iron Age, everyone's fortune is dormant. In the Golden Age, the fortune is awakened. Only the One Father awakens the dormant fortune, gives directions and creates your fortune. He sits here and awakens the fortune of your children. As soon as a child is born, his fortune is awakened. As soon as a child is born, he is aware that he is an heir. In reality, this is an unlimited aspect. Your children know your fortune awakens and then becomes dormant every cycle. When you become pure, your fortune awakens. It is said, a pure household ashram. The word ashram refers to something pure. There is the pure household ashram, and in contrast, there is the impure relation. It would not be called an ashram. Everyone follows the household path. Even animals have that. Everyone creates children. Even animals are said to have a household path. Your children now know that in the Golden Age, you were deities who belonged to the pure household ashram. Their prince, its son, full of all virtues. You yourselves also used to sing thus. You now understand that you are once again changing from humans into deities. There is the deity relation. Brahma, Vishnu and Shankar are also called deities. Salutations to the deity Brahma. Salutations to the deity Vishnu. However, for Shiv, they say salutations to the Supreme Soul Shiv. There is a difference. Shiv and Shankar cannot be called one and the same. You had stone intellects and are now becoming those with divine intellects. Deities are called those with stone intellects. According to the drama plan, when it again becomes Raman's kingdom, they have to come down the ladder. They have to change from those with divine intellects into those with stone intellects. Only the One Father makes you most intelligent. He makes your intellects divine. You come here to become those with divine intellects. There are temples to the Lord of Divinity too. Gathering spectacles there are, but no one knows who the Lord of Divinity is. In fact, only the Father makes you divine. He is the intellect of the wise. This is nourishment for the intellects of your children. The intellect changes so much. It is said, see no evil. This does not refer to monkeys. It is human beings who have become like monkeys. Apes are compared to human beings. This is called the forest of thorns. They continue to cause one another sorrow. Your children are now receiving nourishment for your intellects. The unmuted father is giving you nourishment. This is a study. It is also called the nectar of knowledge. It isn't a question of water, etc. Nowadays, they call many things nectar. They even say that the water of the Ganges is nectar. They wash the feet of the deity idols and drink the water. They keep that water. They consider it to be a special drop of nectar. They don't tell those who take that drop of water that it will make them pure from impure. They call the water of the Ganges the purifier. They say that when a person dies, he should have the water of the Ganges in his mouth. They show that Arjuna shoot an arrow and the Ganges emerged from where it struck the ground. He then gave someone nectar to drink. Your children have not shot any arrows. There is a village where they battle with bows and arrows. They say the chief of that place is an incarnation of God. The father says all of them are gurus of the path of devotion. There is only the one true Sadguru. The bestower of salvation is only the one, and he takes everyone back home with him. No one apart from the father can take you back home. It isn't even a question of merging into the Brahma element. This play is predestined and it continues to go around in an eternal cycle. You now know how world history and geography repeats. Human beings, that its souls, don't know their father, the creator, the one whom they remember and call out to. Oh God, the father, a limited father would never be called God, the father. They say the words God, the father with a lot of respect. They see that he is the purifier, the remover of sorrow and the bestower of happiness. On one hand, they say he is the remover of sorrow and the bestower of happiness. And on the other hand, when they have any sorrow or their child dies, they say that God gives happiness and sorrow. What did God do? He took away our child. They then insult God. They say God gave them a child. So if he then took that child away, why are you crying? He has gone to God. No one cries in the golden age. The father explains there is no need to cry. That soul had to go and play his part according to his karmic accounts. Because of not having any knowledge, human beings cry so much. Some even go crazy. Here the father explains, if your mother dies, eat halwa. Even if your father dies, eat halwa. Became a conqueror of attachment. Mine is one unlimited father and none other. Your children should have such a stage. You must have heard the story of the king who conquered attachment. There is neither any question of sorrow in the golden age, nor is there any untimely death. Your children know that you are conquering death. The father is even called great death. He is the death of all deaths. You have to conquer death. That is, death will never come to anyone there. Death cannot come to souls or to bodies. A soul simply sheds a body and takes another. That is refers to as taken away by death. However, there is no such thing as death. People continue to sing praise, but they don't understand anything. They sing praise. The father explains, these five vices have completely spoiled your intellects. At this time, no one knows the father. This is why this is called the world of orphans. They continue to fight and quarrel among themselves. This whole world is Baba's home. The father makes all the children of this world pure from impure. There truly was the pure world for half the cycle. It is sung, the king is Ram and the people belong to Ram. How could there be any irreligiousness there? They say that the lion and lamb drink water together there. So how could raven, etc. exist there? They don't understand anything. People from abroad laugh when they hear such stories. The father comes here and gives you knowledge. This world is impure. Would he make impure ones pure through inspiration? They call out, "Oh, purifier, come." Therefore, he must definitely have come in Bharat. Even now, he says, "I, the ocean of knowledge, have come to make you into master oceans of knowledge, equal to myself." Only the father is called the true Vyas. So this one is Vyas Dev, and you are his children, Sukhadev. You are now becoming deities of happiness. You are claiming your inheritance of happiness from Vyas, Shivacharya. You are the children of Vyas. However, so that people don't become confused, you are called the children of Shiv. His real name is Shiv. A soul can be known, as the supreme soul can be known too. Only he comes and shows you the way to become pure from impure. He says, "I am the father of you souls." It is said that he is thumb-shaped. Such a huge image could not stay there, means in the center of the forehead. It is extremely subtle. Doctors too beat their heads to see a soul, but they are unable to. A soul can be realized. The father asks, "Have you now realized the soul?" Such tiny souls have imperishable parts recorded within them, just like a record. At first, you were body conscious, and you have now become soul conscious. You souls know how you take 84 births. It has no end. Some people ask, when this drama begin? However, it is eternal. It is not destroyed. It is called the predestined imperishable world drama. You now know the world. Just as uneducated children are given an education, so the father is teaching you children. It is souls who study two bodies. This is food for stone intellects. The intellect receives understanding. Bala has had the pictures made for you children. They are very easy. There is the Trimurti, Brahma, Vishnu and Shankar. Why is Brahma referred to as the Trimurti? They say deity, deity, great deity. They place one above the other, but they don't understand the meaning of that at all. How could that be Brahma? Because Brahma is also called the father of people, means Prajapita. How could he be a deity in the subtle region? Brahma, the father of people, would have to exist here. Thus things are not mentioned in the scriptures. The father says, "I enter this body and explain to you through this one. I make this one my chariot. I come at the end of this one's many births." This one also renounces the five vices. Those who have renunciation are called yogis rishis. You are now Raj rishis. You make a promise. Those sannyasis renounce their homes and families and go away. Here husband and wife live together. You say that you will never indulge in vice. The main thing is vice. You know Shiv Baba is the creator. He creates a new creation. He is the seed, the truth, the living being, the ocean of bliss and the ocean of knowledge. Only the father knows how he carries out establishment, sustenance and destruction. Human beings don't understand these things. Your children now know all of these things, and so you are able to explain to everyone. Achha, to the sweetest, beloved, long lost and now found children, love, remembrance and good morning from the mother, the father, Bab Dada. The spiritual father says, "Namaste to the spiritual children. The spiritual children says namaste and good morning to the spiritual father. Essence for the dharana. First point, each soul has his own karmic accounts. Therefore, when a soul leaves his body, you mustn't cry. Become a complete conqueror of attachment. It should remain in your intellect that you belong to the one unlimited father and none other. Second point, renounce the five vices that spoil your intellect. Become a deity of happiness and make everyone happy. Never cause anyone sorrow. Blessing, may you be knowledgeful and finish in vision of dislike with your merciful vision. Explanation, the children who know the sanskars of one another and have deep love for transformation of sanskars never think, this one is always like this. Such children are said to be knowledgeful. They look at themselves and remain free from obstacles. They have sanskars of being merciful like the father. The vision of mercy finishes the vision of dislike. Such a merciful children never have any conflict among themselves. They become bhakti and give proof of themselves. Slogan, those who always think of God are carefree emperors. They cannot have any type of worry. Om Shanti. Invaluable virtues of Mateshwariji. The eternal element of light is the silent lord and the corporeal world is the playground. The resident of souls is the eternal great element of light where they are free from their bodies playing any part that its souls are in a state beyond happiness and sorrow, which is also called the silence lute, the place where souls intact their parts with their bodies is the playground. That is the corporeal world. So there are two main worlds. One is the incorporeal world and the other is the corporeal world. People of the world say, for the sake of saying it, God is the creator, the sustainer, the destroyer, the one who sustains us, who kills us, who burns us. So he is the one who gives us happiness and sorrow. When someone receives sorrow, he says, oh God, your dish is sweet. Everything dished out by God is sweet. But that is inaccurate knowledge because that is not God's duty. God is neither the remover of sorrow nor the bestower of sorrow. To take birth, to die, to experience happiness and sorrow is all the sanskars of human beings. It is our parents who give us physical birth and people come into the relationship of father and son according to their karmic bondage. In the same way, the father of souls is the supreme soul. So how does he create and sustain the unlimited creation? He is the creator of his three forms of Brahma, Vishnu and Shankar. And through these angelic forms, he enables the creation of the divine world, the destruction of the devilish world and then the sustenance of the divine world to take place. These three acts of God are unlimited. But happiness and sorrow, birth and death take place according to each one's karma. God is the bestower of happiness and he doesn't cause any sorrow for his children. Acha Om Shanti.